and gentlemen, welcome to the B-side form. We get together every other Wednesday night. We discuss all things life, all things hip hop, all things morals, all things alcohol, whatever comes to the table, that's what we discuss. I got some special guests with me today. Go ahead and introduce yourself.
My name is Ash, DJ, manager, A&R, bunch of stuff.
I was doing so good on the intros before you guys got this vodka in my system, too. Go ahead and introduce yourself, sir.
Yo, the name is Crazy Lou, MC, producer, longtime artist. Did a lot of things, toured, done things, and I'm happy. And it's my birthday, so
happy birthday, man. The big 5-0. That one's special. The big 5-0 special. Go ahead, so introduce yourself.
Yo, my name is DJ Chuck, the old soul, one-third of the Mighty Mighty on the floor production, DJ, producer, artist. Always happy to come here talking shit with you, Baka.
Do you feel like, you know, a couple years ago I would say introduce yourself, some people were like, what up, I'm an MC, so-and-so, but now everyone has so much different titles. Why is that?
Honestly, technology has changed that out of necessity, man. I made beats not to be a producer. I made beats so I can rhyme over them, like straight up and down, because I didn't know any producers at the time, and I've always had a musical background, and I know what I liked. I know what I wanted to rhyme over, so I just learned it from there. So, and even from the business side, like, I consider myself pretty business savvy, and honestly, I hate the business side of the music business, but I know it because I want to protect myself and know how to, you know, be able to do what I want to do artistically. You know, I have to have that creative control.
You know, I just wonder sometimes where did that come from? Why is it a problem? Because Stevie Wonder never got called a producer singer. He just got called an artist.
And that's a good point.
Producer, like, these days you got to be this and that. It's like, I'm a musician. I'm sorry, I play musical instruments and rap. You know, I don't depend on a producer because I make good beats. So, you know, I should be called a musician, not just a producer, rapper, and have these labels. I'm a musician. It's music we're making. So, all in all, it's like we've changed that over the years, and I just don't understand why we have to label. If you're an artist and you produced your music, so what? It's produced by you. Go listen to the album, and that's all it is. Artist, producer, he made it. Maybe he's got a couple of people featured and this, that, but it's his or hers music.
Do you feel like people in hip-hop have to overcompensate? Because if you can't just say, oh, I'm a rapper. Oh, you're a rapper. You're one of 2 million other rappers. Do you feel like you have to compensate? You have to let people really know?
No.
I really do this?
No.
I feel like I have to do that.
I don't.
If I say I'm a promoter, people are like, right, you're one of 1 million
promoters.
In this
city, it happens. In this city, it's almost like when you meet people like, oh, I do music, it's like the same person that says, oh, I'm an actor. Like, yeah, we got you. We got you. But it's not until later on they find
I'm a rapper is the new I'm an actor, right?
No, it really
15 years ago, everybody was an actor.
No, the new one is I'm a DJ.
Hey, Drac, can you put up my mic a little bit?
I'm a DJ is the new one, man.
Yellow?
I'm a DJ is the new one, man. Like, this year I'll be celebrating 15 years spinning. Like, I started spinning when motherfuckers wanted to be rappers. I was still rapping at the time, but it's like, people can argue technology. People can argue, you know, so many things are why it's a quote-unquote trend. But, you know, cream rises to the top, man. Those who are really about the culture and really about spending the music, they're always going to be around for it. And those who just in it for the hobby, they're going to fade out after a while. You know what I mean? To get back to your question about...
Don't ever worry about getting back to my question, man. This is such an informal conversation.
Right, right.
Ash sat down. She said, what's the topic today? I said, we have no topics. We drink a bottle of vodka and we chop it up. That's it.
I remember going off on what he was saying about... the labels changing. I think that had a lot to do with how the culture changes, because, you know, back in those days, you know, you had to play stuff. You had to either sing. MCing wasn't even out that,
awesome.
It wasn't completely out there yet. It wasn't until the mid-70s. It wasn't even characterized yet, you know what I mean? So now with these new genres of music, I mean, that goes to the conversation.
Hey, I don't know what the...
what is a producer and what's a beat maker?
Right, right.
What are you going to say, buddy?
I was going to say, I don't know what the... documentary is, but there's a documentary out there that was talking about music in the 70s and how the drum machine was going to take over music.
There's still some drummers that are pissed off about a drum machine, right?
There is.
Yeah, well, it was an actual documentary,
off, right?
So
nah,
you should go check that out.
If
go find
I'm a
it.
Drummer and I spend my whole life, just like you spend your whole life DJing, I spend my whole life perfecting and learning how to play the drums, and now I'm easily replaced by a drum machine, I should be upset.
Two different aesthetics.
Yeah, it's not the
same. Some records require live drumming. Some records, you know, you want to
name one record that needs live drumming.
that had a drum machine?
That needed live drumming. That they said, hey, you know what, the drum machine.
But that's why they have bands.
It just depends on what the drummer in a band.
You said Beatles? Okay, so how long do they come out? How long ago do they come out with a song? Before there was a drum machine.
I mean, a great example.
So exactly.
Two great people who you know, brought together in terms of technology.
The roots.
I feel like
Bruno Questlove.
I'm sure they use a drum machine though.
Questlove actually goes between a live kit and has an MPC tucked. The Roots are my favorite band, so it's like
it's not tucked. It's but that's right. There.
So you have. But that's the 1% pad, and also you gotta look at other rock and pop acts. Look at Prince. Look at Nine Inch Nails. Like. Trent Reznor has easily, you know, brought together, you know, both technology and also acoustics. Prince was a master at that. You know, one minute you'll have live drums, next minute he had the Lindrum machine. So really, all from a producer standpoint, all depends what you're going for. There's certain records I'm like, nah, I need a live fill on this. You know, I need some.
When's the last time you said that?
When we were working on our album.
Okay, there you go. Going back to what he was saying, everyone's saying to a DJ nowadays. Does that get you upset?
Yeah, and like I've played gigs before where literally like I'm the only one mixing, and it's annoying because like I would prep a set, like I've gone through and I've prepped the tracks that I know that I'm gonna play and that like I think would be good, and it allows me to kind of freestyle later too, and I'll just see people picking tracks on the fly and like not even mixing them, we'll just fade one track,
drop it on the one
in.
And shit.
Yeah,
I think I could be a great DJ. I think I could read the crowd, make a song selection.
You said something,
but that's what it is.
You just said something very crucial.
That's the difference.
Reading the crowd.
Reading the crowd is the difference.
Not many.
You don't think a lot of people could read the crowd?
No. Hell no.
No.
Absolutely not.
So what do you do about that? When you're at a gig or you're doing something and these other people are calling themselves DJs and you know they're not DJs, you just punch each one of them in the face?
No. I mean, I feel like it's not my job. It's the proof is in the pudding, and who's going to be getting the gigs? The people that can read the crowd or the people that can't?
You get the response of...
If you charge it a lot, somebody else who's not that good at some party is going to get...
But it's also... I mean, it's a combination of that and
being,
who knows.
Being a DJ...
Just being real.
Being a DJ is a little different, right?
Yeah.
Because I could go out and I could have a great time and I could be drinking, I could be talking to all these girls. I'm like, yo, I had a great time. This I was DJ. I guess it was cool. I guess she was cool. It was popping, right?
Yeah.
That has to be a little frustrating.
Yeah, of course.
It always depends on... Look... People,
now, you
don't
know what?
People, go ahead.
One thing, whenever I've gone to a good ass party, and I've been to a lot of bomb ass parties in my lifetime. So, anyhow,
you're 50.
I can remember, I'm not 50, but
he's gonna flip the statement. You know about the fuck this, man.
But DJs is dope. And what I'm saying about the DJ, it's gotta be the DJ, because there's been a bunch of times that I remember and I was like, man, that motherfucker rocked it. So, it's a DJ's, it's up to the DJ. It ain't
but,
up to the crowd.
Do you have that? Do you have that air because you're a musician, as opposed to the average person that goes out once a month?
No, no. I'm
a great time.
I'm looking at the crowd. I'm looking at the reaction of people, my people, people who are just into music, and people who are just there to party. And I myself, I'm looking around and saying, "Damn, this motherfucker is going down," and it's because of the DJ. You know what I'm saying? I felt that so many times, and then there's been times where the DJ, it was just dry because the DJ wasn't. He wasn't filling out the people, and people were just, you could see him stopping in the middle of everything, like, yo, what is this?
What's that old buyer's mentality? It costs more to get it right the second time, and people learn after they hire a terrible ass DJ, like, I should have hired you. And they know better after a while, because, like, you could just tell, like, you could tell when somebody's, like, we're talking about, like, what's the new, like, I'm a rapper, is the new, I'm an actor. Same thing with DJ. Like, oh, when they hear a set from a dope DJ, they go, oh, you really, this is a reaction. Oh, you really do this. Oh, you really
and they're
do
shocked,
this.
Right?
Because yeah, they like, meet, they're really
because
shocked.
They meet so much people that so say to this, or they say to that, and they put them in a box. So when they see someone actually doing it, they're impressed.
Yeah, like,
and they're shocked. Like, okay. I didn't assume that you really did that.
Right, and that's why a lot of times it's showing proof. You know, that's why a lot of folks, when I meet them, I may mention I do music. You know, it's my everything. But I won't exactly give them everything. They'll learn over time. Then they go, oh, shit, he really does do this. And it cements their respect for you even more, you know?
Are you a little frustrated because in 2018, everybody's a rapper? that has to be a little, that has to be a little, no,
I don't know.
It doesn't have to be a little, it has to be aggravating for somebody that actually does this to be put in the same pool as these people that have been rapping for 2 weeks.
No way, no way I'll ever be in the same pool with anybody. I'm on my
But if the average person you meet, you say, hey, what's up? My name is so-and-so, I sell cars. You say, hey, I'm Lou, I'm a rapper. They think, okay, you're a rapper just like my 25 other friends are rappers.
That doesn't happen.
You
meet a complete stranger, they already
it's
know
you don't. It's not bars. It's not about bars all the time. It's about your presence. It's about what you show and what you think you are. I know who I am. I know I'm a rapper. I know I'm an MC. I know I'm a producer. And guess what? I rarely have to tell people that. They already know it from off cuff. And this is real. This is not no, you know, big speaking of myself. It's just really what happens when you feel yourself and when you really believe in what you do. And I believe in what I do. So, and I've gotten a lot of places off of believing what I do. And sometimes I look back at shit and I'm like, damn, how did I get there? Because I believed in myself enough that somebody else believed in me to take me along with them on something. So, you know, I think everybody needs to think like that, that even in this midst of all these people doing the same old thing, you can find your way. You don't have to depend on being like anybody. Just do your thing, and you're going to get there. That's real shit. I mean, it takes you. So if you believe in you, you're going to be you, and it's going to get to you eventually, whatever it is you're looking for.
You used to be in a group, correct?
I've been in a couple groups.
When I met you a few years ago, you were in a group.
Yeah, I was in a group.
What's the difference now being a solo MC and being a group?
Because I was a solo MC before I was in
the
group.
You were a solo MC that was a part of a group, I understand. But which one do you perform?
No. I was a solo MC before I started my group.
That's what I'm saying. You're a solo MC. Sometimes you've been in a group, but mostly a solo MC.
Right.
But which one do you prefer to be?
I like both.
Can't answer that. It has to be one or another.
I would do it with a group. You want to know why? Because people.
Shocking answer.
Because people, when you actually have people to vibe off, you know, because it's cool to be a solo MC. It's nice. It's, you got to, you know, your vibe is good and people like you, but you have to do so much to keep in, you know, your show. Hopefully you can find a hype man that'll help you and help your show and not just be some dude on the side of you. You know what I'm saying? Like I was for a friend of mine.
Some dude on the side of you just trying to get an Instagram photo, right?
Right, yeah. Like, yo, I'm with this cat, you know.
Don't bring your weed carrier up to be your hype man.
Yeah,
ain't
right.
Working.
Hey, look, I told you to leave the blunts in the back. You know, explain. Anyhow, no, but if you have a group, because look, man, I was in a group called Cali. All right, C.A.L.I stands for Crazy Lou and Lolo International. I had one of my good friends. His name is Lolo. He's a solo artist at the moment as well, and he's got a really good music. He's on Spotify right now. It goes by Lolo. Anyhow, we had a really good thing going. We had really good music, but it, you know, in the position of being independent, sometimes it's really hard, you know, trying to come up and trying, you know. But we were doing good. But it still takes so much more work than it takes if you're signed to a label or if you, you know, things like that. So, you know, the push was good, but it just took so long, and people have priorities and people have things to do. So groups are hard to keep together. That's the only thing about it, because you both have ideas, you both, and if things are difficult, but you know, it's a really good thing. Sometimes it doesn't really matter, because you gotta pay bills, you gotta do things, and shit gets real.
It's tough being an independent artist, and it's even tougher when you have a partner. Right?
Right.
You have somebody that has their own ideals. Hey, I think we should do this. No, I think we should do this. And it's tough, man. I can't even imagine.
Yeah, it built me to be a better solo artist. Because now, you know, when I do things, I think back to those days when I could spit off of my homie shit and not skip a line. So it's the same thing that comes to me. You know, when I do something, I'm not skipping lines, because I used to use somebody else's lyrics and know them by heart like crazy. You know what I'm saying? And we could just fly right off each other. So I'm even better for myself for that, and being able to do the.
Would you consider joining the group again?
Not at this moment, no.
What about you, sir? You're somebody that works with a lot of people.
Right. You know, I'm in a group. And I have absolutely, positively no desire to be a solo.
Hey, hold
artist.
Up. I take that back. I take that back. I take that
you
way
take
back.
Back.
Take it back.
I take that way back. That I wouldn't join a group, because I've been a part of a group for a long time. And,
You want to flex out here. You want to spread your wings.
No, no.
You want to do your own thing for a minute.
No. I've done that. I've been doing that. But what I mean is, I've been part of a group that believed in me and loves me. Just because we're not out doing things doesn't mean anything. It just means that everybody had priorities and things to do. This, that was
nothing
different.
Wrong with that. Yeah, nothing
yeah,
wrong with that.
But it's different because one of my group members, who's one of my love, longtime friends, is sitting right here with me, and his name is Gifted, and he's one of the illest MCs Word. In this land. I ain't gonna even front, and I wouldn't be as good as I am or even on this shit if it wasn't for my man sitting right over here in this corner over here, and my man Jay Vinyl, and we go by the Cali Squad. Before I was ever Cali, it was Cali Squad all day, CS, and that's who taught me to be who I am today. If it wasn't for us mixing the records and doing all the shit we did, that's the group of my life that I will always cherish all the way through, because I am Crazy Lou, because they gave me that name. I was Lou before that. What's up, Lou? Do this, Lou that.
They said, damn, this dude's crazy.
Nah, I said some shit about the police. God bless the police. I ain't talking about them now, but I was pissed back then. And I said some shit, and they said, yo, you crazy, Lou. And that's how my name got talked.
That's dope. I respect that, man.
Real
but
shit.
You would you never want to be a solo artist again?
Nope. I actually never was. HFP, Honor Flow
Productions. You know what? It's because you're such a nice guy.
Let me tell you why. I'm going to give you exact reasons why. Honor Flow Productions has gone through lineup changes over the years. 11, 12 years almost. At one point, we looked like the Wu-Tang Clan, like 7, 8 motherfuckers. One point, we looked like the Roots. There was 8 members.
The light-skinned Wu-Tang Clan, right?
Yeah, no, it really
was. Just super nice guys.
It really was, man. So when it got to this lineup now, the three of us, DJs, Lord, and Lemonade, those are two of my closest friends in college. So it was a while to find that chemistry, and for everybody who was invested, because you were talking about everybody has priorities, people leave, people got things to do, but we're all vested in this. And from a creative standpoint, I've done records with other people just by myself, but it's nothing about the energy of having everyone together and going off each other. I have more fun doing that. It's funner when it's live. And I have enough going on outside of the group, from DJing to producing for other people, to it satisfies somewhat that solo, you know, kind of what. But as far as an MC, I have enough to say within the group where I'm just like, I don't need to make a solo DJ Chuck.
But you know that's because you are an even-keeled, humble, grateful man. Not most MCs are like that in
that's
this,
true,
in
man.
This game.
Most MCs are assholes. I'm going to say it straight up. Like,
90% of MCs
no,
are assholes.
No, be real. Like, most MCs, I hate rappers.
Hey,
I'm
with you, baby.
I'm a rapper, and I hate rappers. I'm going to keep it a buck. I think out of the support system, I think producers
it's just
are the
competition,
most
man. You just got to learn. You got to compete. You know what I mean?
Competition is one thing.
Yeah, all good.
Competition is
one
thing.
Bring it. But being an asshole is a different thing.
I am super competitive.
No, because, I mean, sometimes you're in a competition. You might be better than a person. You might not want to, but you're being an asshole just because you're better.
Nah.
You know? Somebody from the outside looking in that deals with hundreds of people. Those are different.
Why you
going
to be?
Those are different.
You're
the
book,
Baka.
You deal with a whole bunch of cats like this.
Hey,
you know.
Baka, yeah. I believe in this way. Do blah blah. Or somebody that's just a complete asshole. We know the difference, right?
I mean, I feel like MCs are the most uptight. Producers are the most supportive. DJs can be 50-50. I'm going to tell you when you know a DJ's an asshole. When they want to play all the hot records.
They can definitely
early
be 50-50.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's when
they're
that.
An asshole. Yeah.
But
you got to have your warm-ups.
Supposed to play
the
hot shit.
Hey, the DJ's standard is
right. There's a code of ethics to that.
Yeah.
When you're the opener, you play the opener records. Yeah. When you're the closer, you play the closer records.
I'm the opening DJ, if I say, hey, you know what, I'll be a DJ, they book me for a 9 o'clock set, I'm going to play every fucking hot song out.
That is fucked up.
Be mad at me.
That calls for the hands, Baka.
Nah, I wouldn't be mad.
You got to be careful with those.
I want to shine. I'm out here with 500 other DJs. I want to shine. What's wrong with that?
See, that's where the problem is. It's 50-50. It's 50-50. So, but that's why producers are mostly supportive of each other in that sense. Like, there's competitive, like, when I hear somebody else do something, I'm like, yo, that shit crazy. I need to go match that or top that. But that's healthy competition. That's where the competition is. But just straight out hating or straight out disrespecting someone
is a
whole
other situation. But why is that hating if I'm the 9 o'clock DJ? I'll ask you the same question, Ash. If I'm the 9 o'clock DJ, I want people to be like, yo, DJ Young killed it. Why is that hating?
You going to be looking crazy at 9 o'clock playing the hottest record when there's like a half open floor. Like,
this is my time to shine. This is me.
There's a way to do it.
Yeah, there's a way to do it.
How do I do it?
You gotta mix. First of all, remixes are your friend. Like, remixes are one of the best ways to play hot tracks without killing it for the closing DJ.
Yep.
Second, you can mix like hot tracks, maybe don't play the whole thing, maybe do like a verse and a chorus maybe, and then mix it in with some stuff that they haven't heard before but has like similar, like similar drums, similar melody.
I love opening DJ that's looking out for me. Why do I care about
actually
the
you have a more of an opportunity
DJ
to shine as an exactly opener, and the reason why I love opening,
I like opening too,
because you can be more creative. Yeah. You can play, you can break records at that time.
You don't have to mix in.
Hey, if you're a good DJ and you got a good attitude, right, I think that the next DJ who's better than you and who's got a better position is going to hook you up. So
you
be cool.
You can't count on nobody hooking you up in this game, man.
Don't count about it. But hey,
you don't have to play. You don't have to play.
Nobody. You never know. You never know. But if you come in with a shitty attitude, you probably never going to get nothing.
But it's not a shitty attitude. I want to shine. I want to be the best.
Well, shining means that you got some kind
of code of ethics.
I know that. I'm just saying.
Code of ethics.
I'm being devil's advocate. I'm saying if I'm a young up and coming DJ, I'm 19 years old. Young Baka says you're gonna spin from 9
that's
to 9:30.
That's you playing 180 at the end of the night.
To me, that's up there with MCs rapping over their vocals.
So what? He's walking in like, yo, get out of my way.
There's a big difference. That's
shit
a big
is
difference.
Taboo.
That's like the fine you got for smoking weed outside the building.
Nope.
The same as man.
Nope.
That's a big difference.
Nope.
Big difference.
That trend has to. If something has to die in 2018, is motherfuckers rapping with their full tracks on stage.
But you
this
don't take
not
those people
fucking
serious,
Soul Train,
though,
motherfucker.
Right? But you
rap
don't take those people serious, right?
Hell no.
What do
you
do?
But you see a lot of cats out there. There's some MCs I've seen there.
They're
night.
Just
like,
following
why
what, every,
you...
what the big dogs is doing. You go to I ain't gonna mention no names because I don't
mention
want nobody.
Mention the name, Lou. Yo, mention the name, Crazy Lou. Live up to the name. see that
okay,
Baka's coming in. Like, yo, you know what?
Baka's right, trying to push you over the
edge. You go to a Big Sean. You go to a certain, and it's in a certain venue. Guess what they doing? They got the track with their lyrics in the background. So if you can't hear them well, whatever, you can hear their track. So guess what? The people who aren't on their level are following what they're doing. They just think it's part of what is.
They just copy and paste.
Yeah,
hey, it's good enough
paste
for this man. It's good enough for me.
You know, I remember my lyrics, so I know my shit. You know, I do a full show without any lyrics behind me ever. But at the same time, I can't expect everybody to be like that. You know
yo,
what I mean?
Yo, Lou, finish that Faka and let's get into this talk, man.
Yeah, let's go.
Because I can see the more Faka's getting his bloodstream. He's like, because at first, like, I'm not going to mention no names. He's like, you know what? Yo, Big Sean,
you just
people rap before
you,
lyrics.
You just pushing him over the ledge.
That's what I do,
waiting,
man. That's what I do. So,
but I like Big Sean.
Things that need to go away.
That was just an example
things that need
of somebody
go away
who does it once in a while. And he's a good artist. Great artist.
DJ trying to shine.
Opening DJs not
you heard this, Big Sean, which
is
probably
which
you
which
didn't
is wrong. I disagree with that statement. But we're saying the things that you think
now
needs to go away in 2018.
Right. Now, rappers rapping over their lyrics.
Okay, so rappers rapping under the lyrics.
Go.
Then what else? Give me one more that needs to go in this music industry in 2018.
Why? Man. If it's a hot song and everybody love it, I'm pretty sure they don't give a shit if he's rapping over it or not.
I'm just saying.
I'm from the
school of, if you come to a show, motherfucker, give me a show.
Yeah, but who get? I mean, it's if it's like I said, if it's a hot song, look, I even know this, and I'm not all with everything, but I understand the game. If it's a hot song and everybody loves it, they don't care if you are rapping over the lyrics. They want to rock
but that's
with you.
Not, that's not who I'm talking about. I'm talking about the 21-year-old kid that has a couple years in the game that performs at a We the West.
He just got a lesson to learn. He got something to learn about himself, about his music, and about what he want to do and how to present himself.
You don't condone that man, that kid rapping over the hooks, right?
No.
Hell no. I was 18, never did that.
We live in America, freedom to do what you want. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to condone you, man. I'm not going to condone it, and I'm not going to say anything against it. It's do you. And
you got to take a stand against some stuff, though, man.
I take a stand against a lot of stuff. What I do take a stand against is people not letting people be. You want to know why? Because you see some artists that I'm pretty sure a lot of people like in hip-hop are like, yo, what the fuck is this nigga out here for? And he's whack. But he got followers like a motherfucker because for whatever he's doing, that's
but that's
you know,
a different conversation.
You are not Britney Spears.
Nah,
that's
all the same.
That's
you better
this
rap.
Kid, hold on. That's this kid makes music that I don't agree with, but he doesn't make, like, little Zan doesn't make music. But I can understand why some people like it. That's a different conversation.
It's just part of.
Well, that's taste. Everybody's taste is
no,
different.
It's relating. He's relating with a certain group of people.
And he doesn't make
you
it
know
for me. You know,
he doesn't,
make, it
doesn't
for
make it for me.
But you can still
you know
respect it.
Right. That's
why,
what I mean.
Why can't more OGs in this game do exactly what you just talked about? Hey, that's not for me, but I can see why some people like it.
Right.
Because they're making money, and it's harder for an OG to make money. I mean, what other reason? If you know, you got some OGs in the game that are still making a lot of money, such as Jada Kiss and the whole, you know.
But you got a lot of OGs in the game that are broke as hell.
Yeah, but I think that's all in them. It has nothing to do with the
hey
game.
I agree with you, bud. But a lot of people don't see it that way.
I mean, I'm still going, and guess what? I'm not. I've achieved. I've not achieved. Whatever. You get what I'm saying? But I'm not blaming on nobody for the things I haven't achieved.
Again, that's because you're an even killed, humble, grateful. You know, you understand the game. You know, you're a man that takes responsibility for his actions.
Yeah, and that's just what I'm just trying to put out to the world.
You right. do that. I try to do that sometimes, but most OGs can't do that.
My point of view on this is not dissing any style. It's regardless of whatever style you do, whether it's boom bap, whatever it's turn up, whatever you do, when you're live, you need to be live. I want to hear you.
That should be a rule.
Regardless of whatever style
you do. That's why I'm
going
to open a club one day for everybody to come in, me and Baku, and you can't come in unless you spit live, baby.
Cotton Club. The Cotton Club 2.0.
Yep. Hey, right there.
So let's do this, man. Let's go to the video that you sent me, man. Okay. Go ahead and introduce it.
Yo, this is our music video, This That Jam. You can find it on our new compilation, West Coast Cali Soul Hip Hop, SoundCloud.com/HFP Music. DM us for some physical copy. We got the camera. Where the cameras at?
Right there. You have four cameras. I love that half an hour into the show, you said, where's the cameras at?
If you want these limited edition copies,
get that.
DM me at the Old Soul HFP. But if you want a digital, SoundCloud.com/HFP Music. Shouts out to Grub Life, who directed the video. Shouts out to DJs Lord, Lemonade, Lunu Sins on the Bridge. This is filmed at my crib, actually, at my grandma's house. I had to tell that story when we were saving for the book. When that's talking, let's get into it. This That Jam.
B-side form, baby. Competition chicken, yeah, they pull your loco. I throw them down, put them down in the chokehold. Kicking face, I'm the master taekwondo. I'm known worldwide from Hollywood to Soho. I be the model, just get money for a photo. Them girls loco, they always up that coco. But we down for the game like Cuban yo-yo. Cooking beats, flipping heat like a metro. Got a shipment in.
This is a remix. We shot the remix before the original video. This is that lead.
Y'all ready? In 5, 4, 3, 2.
A sweet serenade coming through my pillow. Had this feeling since 13 years old. A Jones in my bones and a high of nirvana. Still feel it every time I step in my Honda. I'm telling you, freedom in its ultimate form. Like I'm back at the mountain recording dorms. Every note is a page that's saved in my yearbook. Time travel feelings with every single ear hook. Remember that time to the girl you kissed? Crazy how sounds can assist in reminiscing. It brings a real big smile to my face. Every time it claps and arrests with the bass. With my hands raised up.
Make it dance around, make it lounge around.
one out of lane, one out of lane. This is how it sound when my nine go bang. One out of lane, one out of lane. This is how it sound when my nine go bang. One out of lane, one out of lane. This is how it sound when I spit every day. One out of lane, one out of lane. This is so you know that the click don't play. I don't give a fuck about the set you claim. Tryna ride 30 dicks just to say that you bang. You a lame, but fuck it, I'ma stay in my lane. Only thing that I care about is how the gun aim. Bang, we ain't the same, that's the life of click slogan. Trade 5-7, leave your head wide open. I've been on my G shit since a youngin' in the ghetto. My trigger finger fitted with a new diamond bezel. Every single hater used to be my friend. Now they all sing in groups like they boys the men. A bunch of pansies, go put on your panties. How you gonna win a grand? When your shit is whack, I'm back. Had to go and do some time. Saw a bunch of dead rappers trying to take my shine. Try to diss me, but fuck that, they miss me. The bullets came close enough, but they didn't hit me. Yes, I'm the cancer, I never left, I was in remission. The chemo couldn't kill me, my bloodline was different. Yeah, I'm from the block where they slang that shit. And the rest of my boys about to bang that set. I let them know, fuck it, I'ma get this loot. In the hood, fuck peace, we don't play no truce. One out of lane, one out of lane. This is how it sound when my nine go bang. One out of lane, one out of lane. This is how it sound when my nine go bang. One out of lane, one out of lane. This is how it sound when I spit every day. One out of lane, one out of lane. This is so you know that the click don't play. One out of lane, one out of lane. This is how it sound when my nine go bang. One out of lane, one out of lane. Bang.
Yeah, yeah. I grew up in the ghetto where people could hardly live. Where gangbangers pull up with choppers like Harley did. A generation where they don't know about pocket big. What the fuck? How many Zans you popping, kid? I ain't playing with these sorry ass rappers. Wanna be thugs, I get so called trappers. These fools are washed up. Bitches gotta get they bars up. L2R got them all shut. I'm from a place with kids, keep that finger on the trigger. Where the feds keep watching, cause the mail can be delivered. Who the fuck you think you are, boy, you ain't shit. I got shooters who will light up your whole clique. When you will let off the whole clip. Man, go to jail for years and then come back and do the same shit. Homies got a clip in the cut, just like a barber. His little brother died, so you know we mob it harder. Got caught up, so his son got no father. Grew up and became a crazy motherfucker. Yeah. Northeast is where I rest. I do it for the music, man, I do it to my death. So God, please forgive me for my sins. And once I pray again, release the demon within. L2R, motherfucker.
One out of lane, one out of lane. This is how it sound when my nine go bang. One out of lane, one out of lane. This is how it sound when my nine go bang. One out of lane, one out of lane. This is how it sound when I spit every day.
Thank you, Pina. Thank you, Pina.
Thank you, Pina.
It's so good.
One out of lane, one out of lane. This is how it sound when my nine go bang. One out of lane, one out of lane.
Hot 97's Hip Hop Mic up here on the Upper West Side, you know, one of my favorite neighborhoods in New York. And I gotta give a big shout out to the West Coast owned Young Baka Productions. They out here, we about to do this event, having a great time. Tell them Hip Hop Mic told you, mess with them guys, Young Baka Productions, y'all. Hot 97's Hip Hop Mic up here on the Upper West Side, you know, one of my favorite neighborhoods in New York. And I gotta give a big shout out to the West Coast owned Young Baka Productions. They out here, we about to do this event, having a great time. Tell them Hip Hop Mic told you, mess with them guys, Young Baka Productions, y'all. You know what it is, Hot 97's Hip Hop Mic up here on the Upper West Side, you know, one of my favorite.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the B-Side Forum. We get together every other Wednesday night. We discuss all things life, all things hip hop, all things business. Big shout out to Hip Hop Mike from Hot 97. That was a little commercial right before the show. Showed us a lot of love when we were in New York. We're going to be back in New York in April. And if you want to go with us, man, make sure you enter the Cali to New York contest. We're going to fly the best MC out to New York with us. All expenses paid, flight, hotel, food money. Get him up on Hot 97. Get him performing in Brooklyn. Get him performing in Harlem. Plus, they can hang out with Bach. So what else can you ask for, man? Ooh. We got a special guest that finally decided to show up, man.
Hey.
Go ahead and introduce yourself, dude.
I go by Reggie Rare, you know what I'm saying? Third channel, you know what I'm saying?
There you go, man. A big shout out to Ash for filling in for him while he was gone, man. And still DJing at the same time, man. So that's super impressive, man. What's popping, man?
Nothing, man. Life is popping, man. Hip hop is popping, man. We trying
absolutely
to bring
hip hop is in a good spot or need some rescuing?
Well,
you know, that's a 50-50 answer.
Yeah.
Sometimes people say hip hop is great. Sometimes people say hip hop is dying. So what do you think?
I think hip hop is like steady right now. They're trying to bring something that's not gonna last. You know what I'm saying? And I feel like
hip hop's popping, man.
It's popping. Tell me why.
There's a lot of great music out there.
Yep.
There's a lot of bullshit, but there's a lot of great music.
Starting with all of ours right here.
Yeah, man.
Okay.
What do you think? You think hip hop's in a good spot?
Yeah, man. I mean, if you listen, if you go around and listen, I don't know why everybody click their heels to the radio, man. There's a bunch of music out there that's selling, and they touring places. People I never even heard of. Like, damn, that shit is fire.
Selling out arenas, man.
Yeah, selling out shit in other countries and shit. Don't worry about it, man. If you can't get it done here, just go somewhere else, man. That's if you really want it.
They love
if you
it don't, overseas, man. Like the authentic.
Yeah, everywhere. So you know, just go find it somewhere else.
What color mic you got, man?
Black.
Is no, it's on the bottom. That's a great observation.
Blue.
Hey, Drac, can we turn the blue just a little bit? That's great that you said you had a black mic. That's what do you think about, sir? somebody that's in the Ford, how do you feel about hip hop going to state?
To me, hip hop's been in a midlife crisis. You got to think, it's into his 40s. It's coming up to his 40s. Yeah. And for me, I think in terms of finding new records, here's the biggest change from the 90s. Technology's changed. Now you have technology for more people to make music, and also the ways to get it has changed. So it's not that there's not a lack of great music. It's just hard to cipher through everything.
It's not like definitely that. Not a lack.
Not everybody. We're all music heads. So we're going to sort through everything to find the good shit. The average person is not. So that's where curation and having taste and people, you know, having those voices to push those records come in handy. So there's not a lack of great music because people don't know where the fuck to find it. That's the problem.
Okay. So somebody like you, you DJ, you produce. I think last time I saw you at the Foreign Exchange Show.
Right.
A little show. No
that
big deal. You know, little show.
That was fun.
What do you prefer? You prefer to being on stage and DJing, or you prefer to be in the studio working on your craft?
Man, if I had to choose,
you only choose one. You only choose one for the rest of your life. You want to be in the studio or be on stage? What are you doing?
I got a question for you. Is he getting paid for both?
You're paid for both. This is your life. That's what you do. You could, for the rest of your life, you could perform on stage, DJing at rocking shows, or you could create music and put your emotion in the studio.
You know what? What do you do? If I had to, it'd be live because it's all about human interaction.
Fact.
Like, I love... When you come up with a great record, my next reaction is I can't wait for people to hear this shit.
Fact.
So the adrenaline rush and the connection you make with people to perform live and share what you slaved so hard at, that's the payoff. You know what I mean? Connecting. Music's about connection.
People can still hear your music. You just can't do it live.
That's what I'm saying. You do it live.
Right?
It has to be live.
Life is more of a payback than somebody texting you saying, hey,
what do you mean by live?
Because how many bedroom producers...
Define live.
Live on stage performing your tracks.
Okay.
Filling people's energy.
Is that all you mean by it?
Let me ask you the same question. You could be a studio guy for the rest of your life, or you could be a performer for the rest of your life. Which one do you choose?
Performer. All day.
No question.
No
Crazy
question.
Lou, we want to be on stage.
Hell yes.
We want the panties being torn on stage.
And in these days, you give them money on
panties,
touring.
I care about that.
And the advances.
You know, I do care about it, but you know, at the same time, it's more the interaction, like he said, with the people. And I've had...
That has to be the highest high,
some
right?
Some dope-ass experiences. So I've had a 2,000 crowd and more. You know, so for me, I felt it. You know what I mean? I got to perform for the Lupus Foundation one day with, and I'll say his name. I'm not really fond of him at this moment, but Ty Mack. I got, you know, God bless him because I did get to do this because of him. I got to perform for the Lupus Foundation in front of the Staples Center in front of 3,000 people.
And 3,000 people at Lupus.
Yeah, and it was crazy as hell because I walked through that square all the time to movie theater.
We all go down there, right?
Dude,
right.
For me to stand there in front of all those people, especially people with lupus, and be able to, like, represent what I do, Man, it was amazing, man. Even though if I did one verse, it was just, it was crazy. They afterwards, I had kids coming up to me, asking me, you know, I had a couple of chains on that, and some other things. Like, it's not like the big dogs, but they were like, yo, how can I be like you? And it was a great feeling inside, man. Like, I did that. You know what I mean?
I have kids come up to me too and say, hey, how can I be like you? I say, get the fuck away from me, little kid. Mm-hmm. Just keep it moving, you know.
Damn.
Let me ask you the same. I'm just playing. Let me ask you the same question, buddy. Stage or studio?
Savage Box.
Perform. Off top.
Because it has to be the highest high, right?
Yeah. I mean, my biggest performance was that Fat Lib. You know what I'm saying?
That was a good night, man.
Yeah. I just started a year ago. And for me to even get.
Good for you, man.
20 people out. Word. That's a blessing. You know what I'm saying? So perform. And it was a high. Drake came on right after, and everybody thought that was my song because I was still jumping, and everybody was jumping with me, and I'm like, okay, let's keep it going. And it was like, do it then. So that's why I'm like, perform.
I wish there was a way to clap in with the mic in, but you can't. But I'm clapping for you right now.
There's nothing like that high, man. I've had the opportunity the last 2 years to.
I thought you were gonna say I've had every high.
No.
I was gonna say
good for him. Good for him. I was gonna say good for you.
I've been every high, you know, trying to chase that dragon.
Not a problem.
Yo, being on stage.
You know, I've got a chance to do like the Roxy. I've got a chance to do Truth. I got a chance to DJ at the Greek a couple times.
Okay.
And to do
Little Fan, you fits a couple.
So for me, like, there's nothing compared to it at all. At all, man. Like I said, it's all about connection. It's all about connection.
Facts.
Man. And let me ask you, man. You have a history in radio. What do you think about the current state of radio?
Well, let me put it to you this way. I left commercial radio on my birthday, 2016.
And there had to be a lot of people saying you're crazy, right?
No, they all thought it was. What the fuck
you were having like a midlife crisis.
They were like, what are you gonna do? I'm saying, I'm gonna go work on my music. They're like, what? Like, people were like, where are you going? I'm like, literally. And God bless, like, for a solid year and a half of making all my income off DJing, all off doing beats. Like, I was really making it work. And I left because, like I said, I put in 5 years there.
What did you work at?
So I worked for CBS Radio. It's now called Intercom. I got bought out. I worked at K-Rock. I worked at The Wave. And I worked at KRF. And those and KRF and The Wave in particular blessed me with opportunities to DJ places like The Greek and so forth. So it helped me in a DJing sense as well. It got to a point where...
It helped you with the ladies, too, right? Like, I can't imagine going to the bar and you'd be like, hey, what's up? My name's Chuck. Nice to meet you. Oh, cool. What do you do? I DJ.
It's even better when they...
What do you DJ at? You heard the Greek DJ, too? I DJ there a couple
times. It's even better when you're in the middle of DJing and they walk up to you. Like, you ain't got... Like, being a DJ is one of the greatest things in the world. You don't have to introduce yourself. They already know who you are. Or even when you're a musician. If they see you on stage, you don't have to introduce... They're like, oh, okay, I saw you do your thing. Like, you're dope or whatever.
If you did your thing.
If you did your thing.
Don't get enough credit these years.
DJs get too much credit.
Right.
You think so?
DJs get too much credit.
What? We were talking about this right before you walked in.
Really?
We were talking about how I'm a DJ to new. I want to become a rapper. Like, everybody wants to be a DJ but doesn't know the code of ethics or the skill set it takes.
No.
Like, you can't call yourself a DJ. Calling yourself a DJ without doing the right code of ethics and knowing the skill set is like calling yourself a doctor and not going to med school.
Right.
Like, you got to earn that motherfucker's title.
Did you hear that one story a couple years ago that this guy was posing as a doctor, his 19-year-old kid, and he was, like, checking people out and everything? Anyways,
niggas like Doogie Howser in here. It's like, it's not gonna work, man. Like, nah.
So you went commercial radio for 5 years, so and you said, hey, I'm out.
Right. I got bored. I honestly got bored, and I got to a point where a lot of my supervisors trust my point of view and ask for it, and sometimes I gave my opinion probably when I shouldn't have. And that's what I knew. Like, you know what? I need to go move the needle somewhere else. A year and a half into me doing that, I said, if I were to go back to broadcasting, there's only one place I'd go, and that's Apple Music's radio station, Beats One. And long story short, through incredible circumstances, I got a job there now.
Oh, congratulations.
So, congrats, man. Let's do the clap, the elbow clap.
I've been there now
elbow clap.
A month and a half. You know, they have shows like The Pharmacy, like Selection. They're about pushing the needle. And everybody, I work with the crew I work with there, they've all put a year somewhere else. And they've all came from that school. We're tired of what was. So we're trying to make a new paradigm here. And I think that's the exciting part about it, man. We're about pushing the needle. And we play, like, there's a request show I work on. and we get real requests through the iMessage. And you know, most request shows I've worked on before this, it was already predetermined who we were gonna play. We're actually taking real requests. Like, you know, someone hits us with a big record, I'm like, alright, we'll give that record, if it's hot we'll give it a try or something like that. So there really is, you know, interaction with the listeners. And we're trying to push the needle and make something different, man. And that's why I love working
about
that.
You know what's cool about that is, I forget the cat's name on Shade 4-5. Lord Sear does that. He premieres songs and then has people call in, you know, and it's like somebody's song that's nobody, you know. I'm not saying nobody. I just mean somebody that everybody knows.
He's like, it's nobody. Like, these things
somebody
are nobody.
Somebody who's not found.
And they play the song.
Yes. Yeah, you know, yeah, I didn't mean no disrespect to any artist.
He's like, yo, he played nobody. Like, these little dudes,
but yeah,
if
this
you
is
give him a chance.
They understand.
Someone is on Discovery.
Be talking shit.
He said he's like,
but also
he played these nobody.
The great thing about it also is the editorial part of it. From a writer's standpoint, as I wrote, you know, for certain publications or websites, even, you know, for me, if I wasn't doing music, I was getting close to it. Working in radio, working in journalism. I never liked the tabloid aspect of how hip-hop or just music is covered. I don't give a fuck who you're dating unless it has something
especially
to do.
Especially now, it's just 18.
Unless it has to do with your music, I don't care. You know what I mean?
I made that song because you fucking her, right?
Right, right. So, we have a cat like Zane Lowe, who's like our premier jock. He's asking questions that matter with the music and the editorial part of it. So it's the editorial part and pushing the needle, something new musically. Like, when I worked at commercial radio, I was never previewed to music conversations, what goes on the air. Most 99.9% of our conversations are music related. And I appreciate that about working there, man. And that's honestly the most I can tell you, because I've had to sign a lot of NDAs working over there. So,
but that's the reason that traditional radio is dying, right?
They get that. Yeah. Like, I can honestly.
Well, why doesn't traditional radio get it? Why doesn't the program director of K-Rock or the program director of Power 106 say, hey, we need to switch it up or we're not going to be having a job in 2 years?
Because they're old, they're slow, and they don't care to get their check. They're like, look.
Yo, talk that shit, Chuck. Talk that shit.
Like, hey, look, man, you're going to be old and slow one day, too, so don't disrespect me.
I've worked at a lot of these stations.
They were here before us.
I have homies
that
are at. They're still thinking it's 1995. Like, I'm just I'm just keeping it a buck. Like, and that's what frustrates me. Like, yo, do you realize you're pretty much shooting yourself in the foot? You're not have a job in a certain amount of years because you're not progressing. That's how with the industry in itself. The industry should have never sued Napster. They should have bought Napster, because once the technology is out, it's out. There's nothing you can change.
You can't stop it, right?
You can't
hold it back. That's funny coming from a guy that's trying to sell CDs. Right?
Now,
we gotta get a flex. We gotta get a funk flex bomb over here.
Now I'm gonna connect.
There you go.
Now I'm gonna connect why I sell physical copies.
Go ahead.
Because
tell me, because I think it's a waste of money. Because if you said, Hillbaka, I want you to have this,
right,
I would say you keep it, because I have no place to
play. I'm gonna tell you something that all digital formats are still trying to figure out, even on our side. We're talking about human connection earlier, right?
Okay.
Sometimes you don't feel the human connection through technology sometimes. And we're still trying to figure that out.
Yeah, but check this out.
Honestly, but I'll ask you guys this question. We're all artists here. We're all listening to each other's music. How much music do you get each other's inboxes a week?
You said what?
How much music?
Too much.
How much music do you get in your inbox?
I get some.
Too much.
How much music do you get in your inbox? Whether it's Facebook, email, whatever.
But you know, I listen.
Too many. I listen.
I know everybody
ain't like
me.
Shout out to Track, man. Shout out to Track.
Appealing. Look,
there was an anything wrong with the camera. Track just wanted to get his face in. You know what I'm saying? That's what it is. Every show,
good, man.
He needs to adjust the camera.
You got it right.
And there isn't anything wrong with the camera. He just wants his face in. So shout out to
that. So yeah,
what were you gonna say?
How much of that music do you listen to your inbox? You listen
none.
To your inbox?
I don't say any.
You say none.
I say 3 out of 100.
5%.
Okay, if someone put a
5%, 3%, 0%.
Okay, because it's data. It's all being pushed. If someone put a physical copy in your hand, what is the odds of it raised you listening to it?
0%.
Zero.
Zero. You say zero.
Five. I'd say 5%.
This may not
no,
work.
No, I say five. I'm with him. 5%.
This may not work with every single artist.
But it's going to work with some.
For, I'm just speaking in terms of Honor Flow Productions. Facts. If we didn't have physical product, we wouldn't have any of the sex.
I think
we
you need
now.
Both. I think
you do need
them.
Both. I would not solely rely on physical, and I solely would
not
rely
if you got
on
some dope artwork.
I'm going to say this. Since you have that physical, this is what I do. I have a card.
I have cards too.
Because that, I go to Hollywood.
Right.
And every Hollywood you see, oh, give me. Do you have it? and I go straight to the same person.
That's a great impression.
They go to, oh yeah, and then right. I give them a card, and then they'll be like, oh man, I don't even have a CD player. I will buy right. yours, but it's
I don't
on
have
Apple
any
Music.
Place to play CD.
But that is true though. That this as well as what you said. That's why I bring it out. Makes that physical connection.
Right, because
but
an
you
email,
say
yeah,
that.
Because you got to get
hold
one out of.
But you say that. But when I go to a show, someone says, "Oh, what's up, blah blah blah." Uh-huh. Yo, check out my music. Here's my card. I say, "Great." I put it in my pocket. When I go home, I walk in my door. I have a desk. I toss it on my desk, and there's a pile of 500 other cards.
Right, right, right.
So what do you do? How do you separate
that's
yourself?
That's just trash.
See, now that's
like, at, I mean, see, but you know what happens? But you know what different. Happens? At a certain point, I say, damn, I have all these. And I just take
scoop.
Them all
but
off.
Hey, that's what labels do, too. They yeah. scoop shit like, oh, shit.
It's a different
until
how you approach
them. And they don't come
if you
see.
Give them a card.
That's right.
And now you're making rapport. You're not
exactly.
just giving. You're not just yeah. giving them
it's
a card.
It's not about the card. It's, about
it's
the
all about the handoff.
You're giving them a rapport. So you're like, oh, they're like, oh, snaps. I never seen an artist with a card. I see him.
Every artist has a card.
Nah.
Everybody I know has a card. My 16-year-old nephew has a business
look,
card.
Look.
And I said, what do you have a business card for? He said, man, my YouTube account. I play video games.
But listen,
everybody
listen.
Everybody has a card.
But that's different. Who is he around? That's your nephew. Who is he around?
Exactly.
Now,
my
now,
man. That's now, what I'm talking about. Yo, you know.
Now, look about
it. Yo, you welcome back next
it.
Week, man. You welcome back next week.
Now,
oh,
think
damn.
About that.
I say something good real quick, too. Let me say.
You know what I'm saying? Because now you got other artists, like I was saying, and he was saying, there's just not a platform to be found. Now, when you make that rapport, and you're really consciously getting into them, like, look, this is what my lyrics is about. You don't want none of that? Oh, okay, come to my show. Oh, now you're selling a ticket. Now they got a ticket in their hand. How did they get a ticket in their hand? Because you made that rapport. And now when you did that, and it's just like, oh, snaps, this dude is serious about his craft.
Rapport is the key word.
And another key word is groundwork.
Yep.
You got to make that groundwork. If you don't do that groundwork, then you're really not doing your work.
Let me ask you a question. Ash, the DJ that DJs 500 places, an artist comes up to you and gives you a CD, what do you do with it?
It honestly depends on how they.
Nah, fuck that, Ash. Tell the truth, Ash. Tell the truth.
I work on Hollywood Boulevard too. An artist will like literally throw CDs in my face, and I know that they don't want. They're not just giving me the CD because they want me to listen to it. They want like tips and shit, which is fine. Like I get it, but there's been artists that I have listened to.
Hey, look,
I do rap. So like I put artists
CDs.
Yeah, they give me CDs.
What do you listen to your CDs?
I have a CD player. I have everything. I have tape player, I have everything.
What you got, a 2014
you
Mac? You ain't got no CD
player,
on there.
You got a cassette? You got a cassette player?
I got a cassette
that's
player.
A Mac Air.
Okay,
you ain't
okay.
got a CD player
go.
On there.
So what makes
I also
you,
take every form of payment.
What oh. makes you listen to that artist CD as opposed to somebody else's?
It's the conversation. Okay? The it's not about the card.
Exactly.
It's about the conversation.
Exactly.
Like, if they made a good impression on me, if they weren't just shoving a CD in my face,
right.
if they like took the time, like, hey, I like your vibe, like, I like your energy. It's about energy.
I have never given.
I mean, it could be about energy or it could be about the person that's. I mean, just to be real, come on, let's be real. Everybody in this room would love to, either if you're a producer or artist, would love to make the hit that makes the money. It could be like
what?
Not your best hit, but I'm pretty sure if somebody was gonna pay for it, you put it out.
Well, yeah. See, I'm all about longevity.
Exactly.
I don't even go in the studio thinking about, oh man, this is a hit. I go in.
No, not hit, but I'm saying somebody else thought it was a hit. You didn't even know. But somebody else out there, you didn't really like it all that much. Say you didn't really feel it like that, but
I'm not pitting nothing down I don't like. So
let me ask you a question. This is the Donald Trump question we have.
Okay.
Uh-oh.
Donald Trump's people come to
I've heard a lot of
says,
stories,
hey,
that's all I'm saying.
We like your music. We like what you do in the streets.
Hell no.
We like everything.
Donald Trump wants
you to write a pro Donald Trump rap
100%.
Song.
No.
We're going to listen. We're going to give you say no. You say no, I don't want to do it.
Nothing Trump, man.
Dude,
nothing
just keep
Trump.
Talking. I'm
oh,
listening
okay.
to you.
So hey, Donald Trump likes you. He wants you to write a pro Donald Trump song. He wants to get the orbit vote. He wants to get a black vote. We'll give you $2 million.
I'm going to do it.
My man, you tell the truth. That's why
I'm going to do
man.
It. No, because
my man.
Listen,
I'm you'll go
listen,
through
you
some
do that.
See that
horrible
long,
shit.
You,
listen,
that longevity
listen,
shit without
listen,
the window.
Listen. No, but no, it is going to be.
It too.
Look, you're in history
I'm
now.
Do
you're
this.
In history
longevity
now.
Without the window.
Yo, you're in history now. You're in history now because you made that song. You're in history.
But what kind of what side of history you on?
No. It doesn't matter because soon as you get that, $2 million, you're spreading all good music. Oh, so you're investing in yourself.
What you're saying is you can make up for it.
You can make up total amount for it. If somebody be like, yo, you just did a Trump song. Are you on the TV?
You break them up with 100. You good.
Are you? Okay. Hold up. My whole
you
my
might
whole
not ever
family,
recover
my
from
whole
that.
Family's eating.
Not
my
Crazy
whole family's
Lou.
Eating.
Crazy Lou.
Hey, you might not ever recover from that. I don't know
Crazy
what you're going to do after
same
that.
Same offer to you. We're going to give you $2 million cash in a briefcase. You good for the rest of your life. You can stretch out $2 million. You doing it.
No.
You're doing
no.
it. Come
no,
on,
I'm not doing it. I'm not that crazy,
you guys
bro.
Are
I'm
doing
good.
It, Lou.
My life
no.
is okay. Man. You know what?
If
let me tell you something. I got.
Look
there's more to life.
Spending his money in his
no,
head.
Check it out. There's more to life.
Nah.
You gotta understand. Look. Somebody who hasn't had a lot, or something like that. I don't know, but I can't explain what a lot means. But I've had a lot in my life, and for me to take something at this moment in my life from Donald Trump, who disrespects my people and disrespects me, nah, man. $2 million. $50 billion. All
right, let me ask you another question. Let me ask you another question.
Let me ask one more.
You
know
say,
what
you know what? We can't do it. They say, okay. We know you don't be associated, blah, blah. You write the song. We'll give you $2 million cash. Nobody knows you're going to do it. You ghost fight it. This guy rapping. Then you take it, right?
Straight up.
yeah, my man.
Straight up.
That's what I'm talking about.
But listen, you're still
I'm
an associate.
With the wife chilling.
You're still an associate. But if you do it
right,
if Kanye West could shake,
he's still the will man.
Yeah,
he's still the will
look,
man.
Look, because we know Kanye's do it. Look, there's people who stand for shit. Talib Kweli would do it. Somebody else wouldn't do
Talib
it.
Talib Kweli would take that money.
Yeah,
I'm
he
that,
would
I'm
definitely.
I want to see
he
it.
He would definitely.
DJ
I want to see it.
Everybody.
Donald
take Trump
that money.
Says, you know what? Go find that man.
I don't know. Whoever does it,
they fly you out
this
to the White
choice.
House. Hold on. They fly
you
out to the White House. They're like, yo, this is
popping, man.
They whine and dine you. You know, they come up to you and say, hey, he really likes your production. He saw you at the Foreign Exchange Show. He really likes the way you DJ. We want you to DJ his next party. Just have to have a Make a Milk great hat again on the ones and dos. DJ Chuck, help us
money
bring in that black vote. We're going to give you $2.5 million.
That's an absolute.
What do we write the check to?
That's an absolute no.
Come on,
because,
Chuck.
Let me
we
explain.
Do this thing.
Hold on.
We do this thing where if I feel like you're lying to me, we cut off your mic and you're done with the show.
Nah.
Oh. You're getting wow. super close. You're getting super close.
I'll give it. I'm keeping it a buck with you.
$2.5
you know,
million.
You know
dollars.
I
hey,
always,
just DJ.
I don't bullshit you. I don't bullshit you or anybody
to be
else
the DJ?
Here.
Okay.
Let me, DJ, just put the hat on.
I'll do it all day. You know why? Because you ain't got to talk. You ain't got to say shit. You can say, yeah, welcome everybody. And then
listen,
after that, it's over.
Let me make
nah.
something perfect.
I'll DJ and I'll play fuck
let
Donald
me,
Trump.
On a 100.
With a mask on.
Let me keep it 100% clear because I think I need to make a character statement about who I am and how I run my motherfucking business. There are certain people or certain things, and this is beyond just Donald Trump. It could be whatever kind of organization or people I may not agree with. If I can't look myself in the mirror and feel good about it,
that's where I was going.
I will damn sure.
I can't look myself in the mirror nowadays.
I won't do it.
I will.
I can look myself in the mirror.
Sure.
Sometimes
look myself in the mirror for
the
2.5.
Is wearing a Ravens shirt.
2.5.
I hate this.
The woo! Money is not worth the headache. Nah. You can't be bought.
I
headaches.
Respect that. I respect
look,
that.
You. I cannot
okay,
be bought.
Listen, you
I
see
cannot
that?
Be
listen,
bought.
Listen, this is a term I bring up. It's blessed.
I'm fucking Reggie. Reggie's
look,
the truth
look,
up here.
It's blessed.
And I think if there was 2.5 million in front of you, you'd be telling the truth.
It's blessed to be stressed. If you're not stressed, then you're not really
I'm sick
catching
of being
blessed.
Stressed. Let's take the money.
Look, let's take that money. If I'm stressed and I'm doing 2.5, if he be like, look, I'll give it to you right now. I'll give him a whole song. But
that's
listen,
right.
But listen, and if you listen to my music, I am not for Trump at all.
Right,
I am
right.
all for the people. But that 2.5 is going back to my society. If they ask why I do it, I say, are you feeding me? No. Okay. Then I'm about to get that 2.5 and make my people
decision,
a better people.
My decision is based
I'll
on
go with
how,
the
I'll
anonymous.
How I will feel comfortable with it. I give a fuck what anybody else got to say about it. How am I going to feel about this? Because at the end of the day, I don't know when I'm going to, you know, deal with the consequences.
And there
how
are
going to
be consequences.
This.
In this time right
yeah.
now,
right.
You doing something and you're part of a group of people. No, come on, don't
right.
run.
But there's consequences
this,
of being
but
broke,
this
too.
Point. Is beyond
yeah,
Donald
true that,
Trump.
But
it could be whatever organization or person
that's
you disagree
you on your own.
With.
You might bring your family into that
this
one.
Is just an overall blanket statement. It could
true.
Be about something else you
but
don't agree with.
It's true. My mom
let,
would be
let,
like, what the
let
fuck
the
are you doing?
Show.
But I'm like, mom,
if
are you
Donald
eating?
Trump's people approach Young Black Productions and, hey, we want to put together a show, blah, blah. We would say, thank you, but no, thank you. We're not interested.
yeah,
because,
yeah,
because.
The Donald can't dance anyway.
Because we believe.
I bet you can. He lying about everything.
We believe that we'll make that amount of money in the next few 5, yeah. 10 years it's anyway, exactly, so it's not worth
it. It's about.
But ask for DJ, though. Ask, yeah. Ask for DJ with 2.5?
Nah.
Come on,
that's the last 2.5 I'll ever make.
Listen.
Nah, taking my ass.
No, it's not. 2.5?
No, it's. Hey, I agree with it. Because if that's the last one,
like, no one would work.
If you believe
it,
hold on.
Here's the question. Here's the part Barker Brother left.
If you believe in humanity,
wait, is that 2.5 tax free?
It's $2,000, 2.5 cash.
Listen. Hold on. Everybody in the room, we're all artists. We all paid to play. Yeah, right. We all did it.
Yep.
So if you can't turn that 2.5 to 4.5,
you're in the wrong business. I have turned down thousands of dollars personally.
That's thousands. Gigs. This is millions.
No. Money is.
I haven't turned down any money.
I've
yet.
Turned down money. Four gigs,
my man.
That will take care of my bills because I knew in my gut this is not the right.
So let me let's get this back together.
That's fact.
What have you torn down? Because you can't.
Can I get up and stretch?
What happened? You can stand up. You good? What have you torn down? Because you say, hey, you know what? I don't believe in that cost. Because
we're talking about 2.5. Change your life. Change everybody's life.
No, it would not. You would pay tax and end up with $500,000.
If Trump say you're not paying,
what are you talking about?
He's like, I just changed the tax.
Hold on, chill out.
Because I'm buying a Bentley.
Chill out.
Trump could get away with anything.
What did you say? No.
Let's just say that.
You know what? I'm not gonna speak on those things. I'm gonna keep that.
That's a cop out.
Yo, that's not a cop out.
You believe? You didn't believe? You opposed that belief or that group or that organization so much that you said I will not take your money. So
well, not just even groups, even just or people, organizations, or just people I didn't like. Like for example, like on a lighter note, I won't DJ any of my ex's weddings.
Okay.
That's one.
That's a good rule.
Shit, I'll DJ my ex's wedding. Nope. Paying me, man.
Nope.
Yeah, hell yeah, I'm with you.
Hey, yo, give it up for.
You know what?
Hey, don't talk to me this whole time. Just DJing.
You good?
You stay over there with him.
Yo. And the other part about it was the dude she was with. You can tell
this happening.
This did happen.
Breaking it down.
This did happen.
So this is why
he said, you know, I wouldn't do this. Plus the dude.
So hold on, it wasn't just the money. It was variables.
It was like, yeah.
Let's take it back down. Let's bring it. What happened?
Okay, so. This girl I knew in college. No, he started chill, whatever the case may be. And she always wanted, you know, something more and so forth to go beyond what we're doing. I was just like, you know,
Chuck's like, I'm out. You can't tie me down.
Is your middle name Maury?
You know people that are good to you but not good for you? She was like that.
That's like me in fast food. Like, it's good to buy. It's like,
so
like
yeah. She hits me like 2 years ago.
I agree with you.
We get into a debate about, like, look, this is why I probably won't work out. I'm just being honest with you. She hasn't talked to me for a year. A year later, she hits me.
You're still talking about a relationship, but she's asking to DJ her wedding.
No, I'm getting to that. So relationship won't work out. Like, we don't talk for a year. A year later, she hits me out of the blue one morning and goes, hey, I got a gig for you. I want to DJ my wedding. She with this guy for a year and I decided to get married. I'm like, she's like, well, it's my wedding, and I feel like you would know the perfect things. I'm like, wait, not my wedding. He means y'all wedding, right? So it's like almost kind of like a way of saying, look what you missed out on. So you're going to watch me marry this other dude, and I want you to play the music for it. I was just like, the energy just wasn't right.
But you said something about her husband did what? Right.
She was with the dude for a year, and they got married. Like a year after, I said, this ain't going to work.
We got to write a song about that shit
one
right
of my
there.
Exes yeah. Let's go. One of my exes comes up to me. She said, Baka, I want you to throw the after party. I want you to throw the reception of my wedding. We're going to pay you X amount of money. I said, let's do it, bro.
Let's do it.
There's some people who are like, get the money. I was just like, but you know what?
You know why I like Baka? Baka is a cold motherfucker. And you know what? Two cold motherfuckers, me and him, we stick together. And he stuck with me and I stuck with him. Guess why?
Because
we some cold motherfuckers. We looking for the bigger thing.
But there was
my grandmother said get the money. I was like,
and my man over here. And my man over here.
But there was something.
And my DJ in the back over there.
There was something going on. If she asked you to be a DJ, she could have went on Craigslist.
That's true.
She could have gone on Craigslist and asked 500 other people to be a DJ.
For 10,000,
actually. Because she wanted to see, hey, what's popping? You see me out here. You see me look good. Maybe she wanted to make you feel bad. Or what?
Right.
I would take that money.
I think she asked to really get to your mental.
Yeah, I'm
really
like,
get to, just to, just to, just a mental. She wanted
so let's
to see
do this.
If she was
let's
over.
Let's call on the phone. Let's ask.
Oh hell,
let's do it.
Not doing
let's
that.
Do it. Pin her on
speaker. Is this the Jerry Maury show?
Not doing that.
The Jerry Maury show.
So we have the Brand Split podcast. And there's about four of us on it, you know. And I try to get people to call their ex-girlfriends all the time. That's the best thing. And sometimes it works out, sometimes it doesn't. So Next time you're on the Pan Spit, we'll have you do that.
Oh, hell yeah. If you want to hear about my exes, you need to hear about this new On the Flow production record coming out this summer. You hear about it.
Crazy Lou. An ex comes up to you and she says, hey, I know it's been a few years since we talked. I would really like to be performed at my wedding.
Hell yeah. How much you charge? How much you paying?
My man. Right. There you go.
I'm for real. I'm really for real. Like, look, if I haven't seen you in so long and you asking me to perform.
If we're broken up, all that's gone.
I'm a performer. Guess what? Not charge.
Facts.
So guess what you're going to do? You're going to pay me if you want me at your wedding. Double. That's it. I don't care.
Double.
Let's go
good
to
for
DJ.
You. I'm happy Ash, for you.
Your ex comes up to you and they say, hey, I want you to DJ my wedding. You say, where do I sign up?
I do it, there and I go. Bring my boo that's 100 times
hotter. You bring the hottest, chick out, right?
She flexed on me.
Bring the hottest chick out.
I ain't gonna lie, girls always got the best answers and shit. We fucking over here like, man, I don't give a fuck. I'm just gonna get the money.
Right.
She over here like, I'm gonna bring my hottest boo.
So you do it, Lou.
Yeah, oh yeah. It's,
you do it,
it's cool, man. I get over shit.
It all depends on, I said no to that, but also the relationship with the person. It's like, everything's cool, and you kind of like, how things ended, all right, maybe so, maybe not.
I've never had a healthy break up in my life.
Oh, they're fucked up.
Yeah, I wouldn't know.
You know what I mean? It's one thing to mess around with somebody. It's another thing to be in a relationship with somebody. That's a whole different. But I will say, you know, the other thing is when I DJ.
Did
cool.
you tell that ex that you worked at Apple?
What'd he say?
Does she know you work at Apple?
I don't know.
Oh, you no, know. Yo, he know. Said the pick. You know. Said the pick.
I don't know.
Oh, man.
I
don't know. He said,
she doesn't follow me on Instagram.
I don't know.
She doesn't follow me on Instagram.
It's one of those things like, oops, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to send you that picture. Hope you have a good day. Young Chuck's out here doing it.
She wanted someone to take her to Disneyland every weekend. She married some dude that works at Aerospace. So, yo, you can have that. Go ahead.
Yeah, no.
You could have that.
Go ahead.
That ain't even my man at.
Go ahead. Do work for Aerospace.
Are you in a relationship right now?
I am not.
Is it tough having a relationship and being in the music industry?
Yeah. You try to think of an appropriate way of answering this. I have to be with a woman that has a lot of patience. And you know what? The other thing I figured out, especially in the past relationships I had, is they had to be as busy as I am. Either you're both making moves or you're both not doing shit. Because you can't have someone whose ambition is here and someone who's right here. If you're both ambitious, it's going to work because you both understand what you're going through and what you're trying to go after. You know what I mean? If you're both not doing shit, hey, you're both not doing shit, you're both on an equal level. But if you're not equally yoked, yo, the shit is not going
to
work.
I have to disagree with that.
Go ahead.
Ooh, talk that shit, Reggie.
I have to disagree because, first of all, for me, for experience.
You gotta finish your vodka, Reggie, but go ahead.
Hey, this does have to do with hip hop. You're right.
Yeah, I'm gonna finish that because I'm feeling that. I'm gonna finish that though. But I'm gonna have to disagree because say your girl isn't ambitious and she's content with where she's at.
Okay.
Right? She already got a job.
Right.
She already got a house. You know what I'm saying? She don't see the bigger picture. But you do, but she's content. So while she's content and you on your grind.
Right. I mean, if she's
but that's easy for you to say. She's content. She has a job. She gets home at 5:30 at night, and she's like, "Let's hang out." You say, "Hey, I got this gig. Hey, I got this interview. Hey, I got this whatever I have to do. I gotta go to the studio. I got. What do you do? Are you in a relationship right now?
Telling the truth.
It happens.
You do what you have to do. Hopefully, you have an understanding woman.
You go with your heart. You go with your gut, and be like, "Babe, let's be 100, babe. Do you want me to go? No, I don't. No, I don't. Well, I have to go. It's a difference from what you want and what I have to do. We both need to be good.
Understanding.
And if she don't understand that, then she just. If she really want to be with you,
so does your girlfriend? Does she understand what's going on right now?
Hell yeah.
You hustling. You out here trying to make it.
Yeah, she knows. We've been through it.
But you know that's you know that's tough to find.
You're gonna go through course.
Yes, but you're gonna go through it for years. You're gonna go through it for years.
Crazy Lou, something that's in a healthy, steady relationship. How do you balance it?
Kisses on the lips.
Yes.
Yes.
But, how do I? I take it day by day, man. It's been really, you know, she helps me, I help her. She's very smart, and not only that, man, it's really about, you gotta kinda block out the shit in the world, because I ain't gonna front, like, you know, it's I like to dress nice. I like to smell nice. I like to do all the things a man likes to do.
And you're humble about it, too.
As you should.
Right.
But it does attract, you know, because a lot of, I don't know if a lot of men do that or not, but for me, it does, you know, and I do that, and it attracts. But you got to block that shit away, man. You got to, I don't know.
What does that mean? When these women are trying to talk, you have to block it out?
just got to know your priorities in life, man. Right. You gotta
what's
know,
important to you? Right. Who's yeah. important to you?
And who's right. important right. to you and how they're important to you. Not just, you know, like, and not in a selfish way. It has to be like, yo, they're important because if I know if they were gone, it wouldn't feel like this. You know what I mean? And that's real
what's
shit.
What's the point of doing it all, right?
Right. right. And there's nothing to gain out of it other than some change and some misery and some other shit that might come with it. Not saying that will happen, but...
But you know, some change, some women.
It's really in your mind. It's really what's going to affect you. Because it would affect me. It would affect my life. It would affect my music. It would affect shit really bad. You know what I'm saying? And I'm not going to sit here in front and act like every man and every woman has had their times in their life, in their relationship where they just didn't know exactly what they wanted, okay? And especially if you're in a long relationship, it's gonna take a long motherfucking time to figure. Sometimes you fall off, sometimes you're great, but it's on and off, man. You know, not on and off like bad. It's just mean your mental changes, the things you learn in life, the things you know, people you meet, and sometimes you know you just have to know that this is something I have to always work on. And I can continue relationships with people, just not in certain ways, you know, and not, you know, just have to respect people. It's just about respect, man. Do you respect your fucking self, you know, first, you know what I mean? And it starts with that, and then you go off and you respect people. Like, I'm going to give you an example. I respect you, B. You want to know why I respect you? You call me, man. This is real shit. This man calls me all the time. Texts me to tell me, I got a show for you, E. He keeps me going, man. Even though I might be doing other shit. Let me tell you something. I'm going to give him up. I don't care if it costs. I don't care. Whatever it might be. Five people come out. I was supposed to get 10. It don't matter. You know why? Because my passion and the thing I do that I love from my heart, bro. I swear I cry over it because it hurts sometimes when I can't get the things I need. But you know what? People like that is the reason I stay loyal and stay real with myself because they need me to be real. He's not going to call me if I wasn't real. I believe that. I believe facts. He wouldn't have a...
Because there's 100 other people we could call, right?
Facts. Straight up. Facts. He got a lot of artists behind him that's like, yo, I'll do it tonight, B. But he calls E. And I appreciate that, B.
Always,
straight
man.
Up.
Always, always. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Young Ash, we're going to put you on the spot, too. You in a relationship right now?
I have interests.
Oh, what does that mean?
That's a great
again, she
answer.
Always has the best answers, right?
That's a great
What
answer.
Does that mean?
It means I have interest, but there is not one person that I am obligated or committed to.
She's
you
discerning.
You out
right
here
now.
Playing the field, Ash.
No, just...
Ash, well,
she's,
okay, Ash,
she's discerning.
It, man.
She's discerning. Damn. She's got a couple prospects. She's trying to figure out who to draft pick on.
But, I mean, like you said, like, DJ schedules are crazy. Like, I'm notoriously single out of, like, all my friends, and it's because I have a crazy-ass schedule. Like, I get home at 3, 4 in the morning. If I was with someone, that person would want to be like Netflix and chilling at like 9. Whereas like you can't do that if you're a DJ. Like 5 hours and better, you're gonna be out playing gigs. So like if someone is going to be with me, they need to, you know, they need to run the race. They need to see if they can handle that kind of schedule. And if they can't handle it, then
well, it's gotta
be
a...
relationships. Have people been able to understand the schedule?
Nope.
That's why they kick rocks, right?
Nope.
There
yep.
you go. I respect it.
Is it just about your schedule? Is it just about your schedule?
No, and that's
good question.
The thing.
Good question.
That's the other thing is that it's not just about my schedule. So like if they have an early ass schedule and I have a late ass schedule, it's not gonna work.
You have to be realistic about it. Hey, I hear what you're coming from, but
thank
you.
You
get off work at 5 o'clock, I go to work at 9 o'clock and I'm gonna be gone all night. I'm gonna be in a hot ass club. It's gonna be people that say, you know, throwing themselves at me stuff, right?
Yeah.
There you go. Alright guys, this is a good segment. We still don't know why you have the CDs, but they, you know, make it happen. Tell people where they can find you at, man, all the good stuff.
Yo. You can find me on Instagram and Twitter at The Old Soul HFP, at The Old Soul HFP, on theflowproductions.com. Got a couple things coming up. Shout out to Unwrapped Hip Hop, Street Glyphics Hip Hop Festival, San Bernardino, Catholic San Bernardino this Saturday. I'm DJing that. We got a hip hop house EP out with our man Jeff the Jacker out called Jacker and the Flow. That's on theflowproductions.com. Trying to think of anything else. Oh, and I mean, we're talking about Radar earlier, but I had to give my shout out to the OG Roland Bynum at Radio Free KJLA. He's playing my mixes on the air. Progressive Nostalgia. There'll be a new volume of that next Saturday around 7:30, 8 o'clock, 8 a.m., something like that. And last but not least, most importantly, HonorFloorProductions.com. We got a new album coming out. Looks like this spring. So, like I said, if you don't remember anything I said, HonorFloorProductions.com. You can find everything up there, man.
HonorFloorProductions.com.
can we call your ex-girlfriend up right now?
We are not calling her right
now. Just go for a try. Young Lou, where can they find you at?
Yo, you can find me at Crazy Lou Everything. And that's CRAZZYLEW. I am the only Crazy Lou in existence. So when you find it, you will find me. And I got a lot of things coming. I got a song that's out right now. And actually had a little mishap. I'm going to let everybody know. So tomorrow, it came out today. Had a little mishap. Had to take it off. It's called Your Shine. It's going to be on every streaming service, iTunes, whatever you want, Spotify, whatever you have, Tidal. It's produced by me and written by me. And yo, just go cop it. Go do what you can. Be out. It'll be out like by Friday. So please go check it out when you get a chance. Your Shine, Crazy Lou. Peace.
I'm putting you on the spot. You answering this college New York contest?
Yes.
There you go. Happy birthday, man.
The thank you very much. Oh, shit. I'm about to drink ashes.
Happy birthday,
shit.
Man. Happy birthday.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. It's been a pleasure with y'all, man.
What can the people
likewise,
find you at,
likewise.
Man?
Reggie Rare on everything. That's R-E-G-G-I-E-R-A-R-E. I got a mixtape out, you know, an EP out called 93, and another EP coming out called DBP, Death by Poetry. You can find that on every surface, Spotify, iTunes, everything. I want to give a couple of shout-outs to Mom first, God second, you know what I'm saying?
My team. Ooh, that's kind of risky, well, man. Mom over God?
Yeah, well, Mom's right now, right?
There you go, there you
I'm
go.
I'm
going
to be honey, like, all the time. Mom's feeding me right now. God, you
God created
me.
Moms.
God, you feeding me too, but you blessed me with my mom, so you know what it is already. You Word. Know what I'm saying? But Third Channel, Young Production, Ashley, everybody for coming, you know what I'm saying? And, man, Reggie Rare on everything. Third.
Word. Reggie Rare.
Young Ash, where can the people find you at?
Instagram, What's Up Ash? Twitter, That's Dope Ash. Facebook, DJ Ash.
There you go, man. My name is Young Baka. You can find me at Young Baka, at Young Baka Productions. You can find us this weekend. We're going to Las Vegas. The first edition of We the West Las Vegas. The whole crew is flying out to me, Slum the Resident, 498 The Fam, Stevie D, Young Leho. We're all going to be out there. We're going to all be partying. We'll be out there for 3 days. So if you're in Las Vegas, you want to go to the show, go ahead
I'll
and
be liking the videos on Instagram.
There you go, man. Shoot me a text. 310-345-2909. Shout out to Drack, our producer. B-Side Form. B-SideChannel.com, man. B-side. We also have B-side. Pop That and Crazy Girls, February 26th.
Crazy.
Exotic Dancers. And performers. What's your crazy story about Crazy
Girls? Oh, okay. So long story short, I was there for my cousin's bachelor party.
15th birthday?
No.
There you go.
His bachelor party, right? So we're in the corner, whatever, kicking it, girls coming over, throwing money, whatever. And I hear this girl go, Chuck?
Ooh.
And I was like, who the? And it's a homegirl of mine that works at a store. I'm not going to say what store. It's a store around the corner for
you
the crib.
You say the store?
All right. She worked at the CVS around the corner from my crib. And I was like, oh, shit.
Where do you live? You live in Mid-City? Where you at?
So I'm like View Park, you know, there, Inglewood over there, man. So there's a couple CVS's. You don't know what CVS I'm talking about. But she working there. So turns out I had a little crush on this chick. And, yo, she was a stripper, man.
She was a dancer.
She was a dancer, dog.
And then what do you do? You over temper, right?
Oh.
Yo, can we get a quick freestyle in before we leave?
This ain't the place, man. This ain't the place. You off that Tito's, man.
Yo.
You off that Tito's. So what happens? You overtipped her.
I overtipped her. And
does it advance after that?
No, it doesn't advance. But I saw her at CBS. I saw her this past week. She would just kind of give me that wink like, what's up?
I love
what's
it.
Up?
Why is she at CBS? She had crazy girls. They make a lot of money.
Just extra dough, man. It's hard out here for
that's
a
that's because she wants a new manager. You know.
But it was just crazy, man. And it's like, okay, y'all knowing that Bruno Mars song, 24 Karat, 24 Magic, he says hashtag blessed. She got a tattoo blessed like right on her ribs. So every time I hear that line.
And that's the first time you saw her when she was stripping, right?
Yeah, I was like, oh, I'd say, well, those UCVS khakis were not doing her justice.
I think CVS, I think there's a lot of women that are promiscuous that won't get CVS.
No.
I think there is. I hear stories about CVS all the time.
Them polos and khakis and I do no
way. Hey, I got a CVS around the corner from my house. It'd be freaky at night.
I don't want to get you in trouble, man.
I'm not going to lie. No,
you off to 101, right? You don't want that one. That's going to get you in trouble.
I know. Trust me. That's why I don't go there.
What's going on behind the pharmacy?
Yo, with that being said, man, if you want to enter the Cali to New York, hit me up. We're also giving $2,000 to the best MC. And it's going to be the first time I announced it. I haven't said anything yet. But All-Star Weekend, we got Crooked Eye coming out. We got Blue coming out. And we got DJ B.E.'s and Power 106, man. We're going to be rocking all weekend. Mess with us, man. Young Bach Productions, youngbachproductions.com. My boy Crazy Lou's going to go out with a freestyle. B-side form, baby. It's all you, Lou.
Yo. Yo.
Birthday freestyle.
Right. Birthday freestyle. Here we go. It's time to stand up. Stand up for the rights of any, many. Yo. Yo.
That's yo. That Tito's freestyle.
I've been living shit. I've been doing things. Guess what, man? I still want to sing the song that God gave me in my heart. I got to do this, man. There was a start, now it's a beginning. So, guess what? This time I'm winning. I got to get shit, nigga. Guess what? I did sin. Yeah, you right. And I don't regret. I got to get some shit. I'm going to do my set because I love what I do. I love that I live. I love that I sit here with these cool-ass dudes. Sitting here chilling, talking about shit, relationships, shit that matters. You know what I mean, man. My head sometimes scattered. Of all the shit I gotta do, she switching up the beat is true, but it's okay cause I'ma do what I gotta do. Thanks, Young Baka, man, for bringing me through.
Hey, you ready for this? Yo, bring it back, Ash, bring it back. I'ma drop some little something on you guys, man.
Okay.
B-sideform.com, baby, we out.
Yeah. Thank you, Crazy Lou. Still out this motherfucker. Seem like a nigga ain't never gonna get the fuck up out of here. Niggas just don't understand.
Yeah. Word to Mitchie, it's tricky and trip where I live. Tripping off the trials and the tribulations to feed your kids. False accusations, no hesitation, we feed the pigs. Mainly off the Jamie until these niggas free Freddy Gibbs. Stop sipping the syrup, made me hallucinate. 5-hour drive on a 5-bun in the oven baking. We got a trunk full of chicken trying to avoid the bacon. Swerving in the caddy, we black and happy and paper chasing. Catching and counting the money and getting all the extras. Unneeded niggas deleted, I didn't get the message. Out for the wealth, so I took me a check of self-invested. No, never neglect. To the ones that left, I got arrested. Leave it to the almighty Allah to find the hardest tested. I never pray for a dollar, just keep my bar protected. Free from infection, a double pump is Trump selected. The world's a dump to the Lord, come back and redirected. They expect drugs gon' sell, who got that new work? Niggas always get killed, cause police shoot first. And we gon' show our grill and buy the shoes first. And run and tell the news to the turf. Do dirt till we get mercury.